So one of the things that we set out to do here, you know, collaborative with the Gates Foundation, was develop systems that, you know, have the potential of making it easier for children to receive their medication. Some of the key challenges that children have are having to take solids, so whether it be a tablet or a capsule. So one of the things we wanted to think about and try and develop was a system that could be ingested but as a liquid. And we wanted a system that could somehow extend a longer period of time for that drug to be absorbed.
The researchers took their inspiration from nature and began to experiment with a polymer called polydopamine, which is a component of the sticky substance that muscles secrete to help them cling to rocks. They discovered that an enzyme called catalase, which is found throughout the digestive tract with especially high levels in the upper region of the small intestine, could help assemble molecules of dopamine into the polydopamine polymer. Through their lab experiments, the researchers show that if they deliver dopamine in a liquid solution along with a tiny amount of hydrogen peroxide, catalase in the small intestine will break down the hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. The oxygen then helps dopamine molecules to join together into the polydopamine polymer. The darker color signals the transformation into the polydopamine polymer.
So what we developed here is essentially a film that forms right over the small intestine. And one of the things we recognized was that we could embed drugs in there and have those drugs be absorbed over longer periods. But what we also recognized is that we could use that film to hold different tools. So one of the other tools that we recognized that we could really include here were enzymes to help with digestion.
The researchers showed that they could embed the polymer with tiny cross-linkers that make the coating impenetrable to glucose and potentially other molecules. This could ultimately help in management of diabetes, obesity, or other metabolic disorders.